Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of Creatnprocess. In today's video, we'll design this logo. And if you look at this logo, there is a pentagon which has been given some effect. It has been divided into four pieces, and there is a patch of three circle in the center and in two in the corners. And later on, the whole pentagon has been rotated to an angle to form the circle, and the circle is formed by 10 pentagonal shapes. And later on, two has been deleted. And so let's begin with the tutorial. To create this logo, we'll first select the pentagon tool, left click your mouse button and give the radius 10, and let's give 5 sides and OK. And after that, we'll create those details to that. So to create that, we'll first use the line segment tool, fill it with black color, make it thin, a little bit thinner, and from here we'll draw out the line segment joining the corners like this. The reason why I'm making this piece like star is because I need these anchor points here so that I can draw out the line. I want to draw this line through passing through this anchor point and touching this corners the same way from here, passing this anchor point and touching this edge. Now you can delete the rest, just delete it out one by one, and we are left with this piece. You can remove the outline here, you can increase the thickness, let's increase to 1.2 I think. Just make it bigger. Select this, make it bigger. So that when we subtract from here, there should not be any piece left here. Next, we need three patches of circle. So we'll draw the circle from the center. From here, draw the circle. Remove the outline and fill it with color. You can scale it up. Now duplicate this, alt and drag, place it in the corner. Same way, place it in the corner. Now select everything on the black and go to object, expand, okay, and in the Pathfinder go and combine it. Now select these and subtract. So we are left with these pieces. Then our next step is we need to give some shade here. To give that, we use the line segment tool from this anchor point. With a shift, you got a straight line and just drag here. And for this, you don't need any color. So you can directly go to object, path, divide object below. And this will divide this piece. Now we need to fill it with color, so we can ungroup that and we'll go and bring this color pieces here. So let's scale it down so that we can use that. Now we'll fill it with the color. So select this with the eye picker, fill it with this color, select this piece, eye picker, select this, eye picker, and select this, eye picker. So you got it. Now select these two pieces, left ones, and fill it with this color. So we've done that. Now we can remove this piece here. Now our next step is to use this pentagon to create a circle with 10 pentagons. So to create that, we'll first calculate that if we use this, if we want any object to be rotated to in a circle and having equal distance between them, to know that we need to do some mathematical concept here. So we need 10 pentagons and there are 360 degrees, so we will divide 360 degree by 10 and you get 36 degrees. We will use that 36 degree to rotate our object to an angle. So but before that, we have taken 10 centimeter, that is 10 point radius. So I'll use this time I'll draw a line segment of 20 and give it 90. This 20 is the double of that radius and click OK. Fill it with some color, stroke color. Now place this here, touching the intersection point. Now we'll group this up, Control G, and with the rotate tool we'll put the anchor point here and rotate this to an angle using the rotate tool and alt pressed, drag and rotate, and place it to angle 36 degree. So just carefully do it. Okay, so that gave it 36 degree. Well, now you can use Control D to duplicate it for multiple number of time, and you got your overall design. Now next step is we can remove this part, we don't need that, and we can delete these two pieces. So we got our overall design here. You can now scale it up and designing part, we have done it. We will now create a text. We'll use the text tool, write out the text, Catalist, and we'll find out and change the color to white, scale it up a bit, and we will check the text here. So this is the text we need for this logo. We'll scale this up a little bit, fit it there. You can place it here, let's scale it down a bit, and we got our logo. This is how we have created that. So with the help of geometry and with the values, we can create the design very accurately. We have used the angle as 36 degree and created a balanced design. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.